What's up, babes? Today is day one in our 7-day detox challenge. This is a very, very, very important day because without this day, all the workouts and all the meal prepping and all the diet that we do isn't going to be enough if we don't have our mindset in the right order. So what I'm going to need today is I'm going to need you to grab a piece of paper and a pen right here, right now. If you need to pause me, feel free to do so, and then let's go ahead and begin. The first thing I'm going to need you to do is write down all of your triggers. I want you to find exactly what is your specific self-sabotage loop, because we all have them. And then after that, we're going to find out how to make it your self-love cycle loop, okay? So I'm going to tell you mine, and that will hopefully start to kind of create a little bit more of an idea for yours, okay? So go ahead and grab your pen and your paper. My first one is a trigger, so finding out what your trigger is. Then the next one is, what does your trigger do? My trigger, it ends up making me feel bad, right? So finding a trigger, maybe it's stress, maybe it's feeling anxiety, maybe it's time, maybe it's something that's happened in your life, right? So some sort of trigger ends up making you feel bad. After you feel bad, it leads me into no motivation. I end up not doing any sort of routine, I end up not preparing, I ended up coming up with all sorts of excuses. Then what ends up going into is bad diet. My diet gets worse, and then I end up not doing any workouts because, again, my mindset is all disoriented because of originally feeling bad. Then it leads me down into the body image where I start feeling like, well, I haven't been working out, I haven't been eating good. So then I'm starting to think of, oh, my body image, and I just don't look good, I don't feel good. And then it continues to keep me in this sabotage cycle where I'm not doing my workouts, I'm not getting my diet in ready, I'm not preparing my day ahead of time, things like that, okay? So my self-love cycle, and this is what you're gonna do right after, is create the cycle on how you can actually stop the trigger and stop the routine by creating a new routine for yourself. So mine is, next time I have a trigger, what I'm gonna do is, if I start to feel bad, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say a positive statement instead. Waking up in the morning and starting out with I am, and a mantra that gives you power. Instead of I'm not good enough, I say I am good enough. I am enough, I am valid, I do exist, I do have potential, and I do wanna do this. Those are things that start to give you that positive mindset. You're in the positive routine at the very beginning of your day. After that, I start becoming aware of my cycle. If I start saying things that I don't want to say, doing things that I don't want to do, I realize that those are triggers, and I immediately go, ooh, I'm starting to go down my sabotage. That awareness right there is what will truly help you break through your sabotage cycle as you start to learn how you can help better prepare yourself. So here's what I do. The first thing that I notice when I am doing my self-sabotage cycle, I go, what is an empowered action instead? And this is what I want you to write down. What are your empowered actions to get you out of your self-sabotage cycle? Mine is, I immediately go into meal prepare. Even if I'm having a bad day, I go grocery shopping and I take 1 hour out of the day and I meal prepare, so I have the entire rest of the week already set up for success. What that does is it leads into my diet, that I'm eating healthy the rest of the week, which in therefore alignment puts me into that self-love cycle. Next, what I do is I start to tell myself that instead of hours long of workouts, that I need only about 5 or 15 minutes. That's it. 5 to 15 minutes of a workout. Everybody has time for that. It removes my excuses away of thinking that a workout has to be an hour long, and therefore it puts me in the routine of doing my workouts again. So that is why I've created the next 7 days to be very efficient, very fast, and our workouts are going to be only around 5 to 15 minutes with each other, so that way no excuses come up for you as well. And when you find out what these workouts are, feel free to repeat them. Repeat the ones that are your favorites and do them again and again and again. All right, and then after that, so I start to feel good from the inside out. I'm starting to feel like I got my diet in check, I'm doing my workouts because I have no more excuses, and that's what puts me into the self-love, the new habit, and my self-love cycle. So I want to know yours. What you can do right now is go ahead and join our Booty Bands community. There's been multiple times you've been able to join the Facebook group. It's just going to be on the link below. Click that link. You'll be able to join our community and tell us about your self-love cycle, the reasons on how you were able to find your sabotage things and how you were able to transition into your self-love. Please share with us yours, as I was able to share mine with you. And then I will see you on day 2, where we're going to meal prep. You're going to go ahead and check your email tomorrow to see that really quick and easy way on how to meal prep. And then after that, we're gonna go into our workouts, all right? See you in the next email.